President. We'll be right on the line, sir. Thank you.
Man had called Liz Carpenter, and I can't hear you. Talk a little louder.
I say we've got a lot of problems, obviously, as a consequence of this. And we'll have to take up and present to you and we'll have of course, we are available and do anything in the world that we can do. We think we've got the situation in good shape now, as we can be. Would you like to say a word to Clark about it?
No, just tell me, could this be true?
I'm afraid so.
Well, who is involved?
Just some of them. It happened at the way in here.
I can't hear you.
Is there just a case of a fella going off his rocker for long enough to get involved in that kind of thing?
What do you say to these other people? What do you explain to them?
Well, we have told them that, I told them that Walter came over to see me this morning and that he has a complete blackout about the period. And Bob, that he did go to this party and he had a couple of my teams exhausted. He had a complete blackout about it and that he doesn't remember anything. Now he does remember.
Did Walter talk to you frankly?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I just can't believe it.
Sir?
I just can't believe it.
I couldn't either, Mr. President. It's the most fantastic thing I've heard in all my life. I thought I'd heard everything. But, no, never know.
Had a bit of this before? Any history of it?
He told me no, but, I had a record of an arrest in 1969. Walter told me no, but since I found out about the arrest in 1959, you know, and then we came back to the house, he's been with Walter all day long, I just didn't have the heart to ask him about that 1959 thing, which we'll have to do one of these days. But the star says that he was photographed by the police. And they took a mugshot of him and they've got down there. But there's no doubt about the identity. So, what we've done is just to
3 weeks, do you?
No, sir. I think that, however, that if we can keep it out of the news story, it won't assume a great deal of dignity. And I think that Walker ought to stay in the hospital a while and then be sent off somewhere. The doctor probably ordered him to go off somewhere to recuperate. But I think we wouldn't be very sensible if we didn't assume that the Republican National Committee has it or will have it. Now they can use this as another problem.
Charge.
Well, he put up $50 collateral, the collateral, and apparently the policeman said that he forfeit the collateral. So the charge is just there on the books, and in effect, no contest, which is what amounts what forfeiting collateral amounts to. Now, I have talked with rather deep call, and I talked with them, and he's gonna look into the question of this the police blotter. What if anything can be done? And he offered to do that. I didn't suggest it, but actually it's too late to because it's known to a week passed before Walker came. Walker didn't, I never heard of his person until this morning. I guess Walker was just praying that nothing had happened. I guess the cop told him that nothing would be known on it, which of course wasn't true.
What did he say to you?
Well, it happened. He told me that it happened. Of course, he's just distraught, as you can see. I think he's just exhausted and had a couple of drinks and was sort of out of his mind.
Mary and Lasker and these folks, various people, that I have been seeing him every day or two for the last few days, and you all talk to him and talk to Mildred so that what his situation is going over to you.
So that what?
What he has goes over to you.
All right.
You follow me? Do you follow me?
Yes, sir.
Mary Lasker and some of them, different, good many folks had been talking to him. Clark has tell Clark about it so that you can go talk to Mildred about it.
Clark and I will handle it, yes, sir.
All right.